Truly the Lord has borne our infirmities, and he has carried our sorrows. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
This morning, in this time of pandemic, we'll be taking prayers for those who are dying. As we gather, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, who through the fact of death itself have mercifully unlocked for the human race the gate to eternal life, look kindly on your servants in their final struggle, so that united to your Son's passion and sealed with his blood, they may come without blemish into your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The Holy Spirit says, "Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at the rebellion in the day of testing in the desert, where your ancestors tested and tried me and saw my works for 40 years. Because of this, I was provoked with that generation, and I said, 'They have always been of an erring heart, and they do not know my ways.' As I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest. Take care, brothers and sisters, that none of you may have an evil and unfaithful heart, so as to forsake the living God. Encourage yourselves daily while it is still today, so that none of you may grow hardened by the deceit of sin. We have become partners of Christ if only we hold the beginning of the reality firm until the end." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice,
harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works. Therefore, I have sworn in my anger, they shall never enter my rest.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
The struggle of young lawyers to make a partner in some prestigious law firm is the stuff of much drama in real life and in novels and movies and TV shows. And when you consider the long hours of hard work, sacrifices, dedication that goes into that process of becoming a partner, it should make something we just heard in the first reading in the letter to the Hebrews stand out all the more. We were told we have become partners in Christ. And that happened without any effort or struggle or merit on our part. It was one of the effects of our baptism. All of the struggle, after we've made partnership with Christ. And what does it mean then to be a partner of Christ? We're given one indication of what it means in the gospel. It is the practice of Jesus to reach out, touch lepers, and heal them. And the question is, are we willing to associate ourselves with that practice as a partner of Christ? Reaching out to those
impulsive. Not to drive them away, hold them off, beat them down, but to heal them, to make them better. In fact, all of our reaching out as a partner of Christ is to have that effect, to make someone better, to heal, to put things that are out of order into order the way they ought to be, is to be the practice of Jesus and his partners. Listen again to what St. Paul said. We have become partners of Christ if only we hold the beginning of the reality firm until the end. With confidence in the grace of our baptism, let us place before God the needs of all people in the name of his Son.
That the Church throughout the world may be sanctified through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That political authorities may receive the grace and blessing of our Almighty God in working to protect and defend the sanctity of life from conception through natural death, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who suffer from disease or illness that separates them from the community may feel the Lord's healing embrace and be consoled in their time of suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our faith community may grow in faith, hope, and love, and be transformed by grace to a life of gospel fidelity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all faithful departed may rest in eternal peace in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
of the souls of James J. Ryan and family, remember especially at this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, receive in your mercy the needs of your people, and ask for them according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord confess the thanks I have presented to you.
Receive, O God, the sacrificial offering we bring you with confidence. For your servants who have reached this world, this life's end. And grant through this sacrament the cleansing of all their offenses, that through though beset by the trials you ordain for us in this life, they may in the life to come know eternal rest. Through Christ, we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Your kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us. Thank you. not see the enemy prevail against them, but may be worthy to pass over to life eternal in the company of your angels. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace.